Okay, the first thing that we learn is that now it says in verse 3, now Israel, and again, since Yaakov's name was changed, now we could spend our whole lives looking at the difference between when a verse uses the word Israel and when the verse uses the word Yaakov, and sometimes both. And there are thousands and thousands of pages that have been written about this, because the name, because as opposed to Hashem changing Avram's name to Avraham, and then nobody can say Avram anymore because that is in the past and it became Avraham. Mm-hmm. When Hashem himself changed Yaakov's name to Israel, Hashem himself still uses the word Yaakov, and many times he uses both in one verse. And in the prophets we find that, because it wasn't a replacement in name, it was a new facet, it was a new dimension, it was a new aspect of Yaakov's personality, because Yaakov, more than the other forefathers, is the whole nation. He fathered the whole nation, and he's the completion of the nation.
Does it really serve as a title? It's almost like a title.
One idea is that it's kind of like Yaakov is the personal and Israel is the national, represents like the nation. And then there's another idea that it's a different level of consciousness, like a higher awareness, almost like a higher glimpse of prophecy, when Israel is used. Mm-hmm. So